Hello, everyone. You got everybody? Well, good afternoon. And this is a very good afternoon. A very good afternoon. Today, we're bringing home Paul, Evan, also Vladimir. Three American citizens, one American green card holder. All four have been imprisoned unjustly in Russia. Paul for nearly 6 years, Vladimir since 2022, Evan since March of 2023, and Alsu since October of 2023. Russian authorities arrested them, convicted them in show trials, and sent them to long prison terms with absolutely no legitimate reason whatsoever, none. Paul, a former Marine, was in Russia for a wedding. Evan, a journalist with a Russian in Russia, was in Russia, signed by the Wall Street Journal. Alsu, also a journalist, was in Russia to see family. All three falsely accused of being spies. And Vladimir, who is a Russian citizen by birth and holds an American green card, is a Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist and was a pallbearer at my friend John McCain's funeral with me. He spoke out against Putin's regime, and for that he was convicted of treason. And now, their brutal ordeal is over, and they're free. Moments ago, the families and I were able to speak to them on the telephone from the Oval Office. They're out of Russia. Earlier today, they were flown to Turkey, and soon they'll be wheels up on their way home to see their families. This is an incredible relief for all the family members gathered here. It's a relief to the friends and colleagues all across the country who've been praying for this day for a long time. The deal that made this possible was a feat of diplomacy and friendship. Friendship. Multiple countries helped get this done. They joined a difficult, complex negotiations at my request. And I personally thank them all again. And I've thanked them personally, and I'll thank them again. All told, Russia has released 16 prisoners. 8 Russians were being held in the West will be sent home as well. These 16 prisoners from Russia that Russia has released include 4 Americans, 5 Germans, 7 Russian citizens who are political prisoners in their own country. One of those Russians runs a human rights organization, Memorial, which won a Nobel Prize in 2022. Putin threw him in prison for voicing opposition to the war in Ukraine. 4 others work with Alexei Navalny, political opposition leader who died in Russia prison this year. Now, they can live safely abroad and continue their work of advocating for democracy if they so choose. This deal would not have been made possible without our allies. Germany, Poland, Slovenia, Norway, and Turkey, they all stepped up and they stood with us. They stood with us. And they made bold and brave decisions, released prisoners being held in their countries who are justifiably being held, and provide logistical support to get the Americans home. So for anyone who questions whether allies matter, they do. They matter. And today is a powerful example of why it's vital to have friends in this world, friends you can trust, work with, and depend upon, especially on matters of great consequence and sensitivity like this. Our alliances make our people safer, and we began to see that again today. Let me say this. It says a lot about the United States that we work relentlessly to free Americans who are unjustly held around the world. It also says a lot about us that this deal includes the release of Russian political prisoners. They stood up for democracy and human rights. Their own leaders threw them in prison. The United States helped secure their release as well. That's who we are in the United States. We stand for freedom, for liberty, for justice, not only for our own people, but for others as well. And that's why all Americans can take pride in what we've achieved today.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.